2008 election with the Democratic Party going in the wrong direction every turn. We see a ship that's headed full blast in the wrong direction. Well, what is our alternative? I fear that our alternative is a Republican Party that's without any direction. It's a drifted sea. We have candidates who are bragging about the fact that they supported universal health care when they were governor of their state. That's not Reagan Republicanism. We have Republican candidates who think that we have to solve every problem anywhere around the world. Send our troops, send foreign aid. It's time we meddle with the world's problems. Ronald Reagan and, yes, in 2000, George Bush campaigned on the platform that we're going to bring our troops home, that we're going to solve the Monroe, we're going to stick by the Monroe Doctrine in the Western Hemisphere. If you still believe what we've advocated for years, your candidate is Ron Paul. Ron Paul is not pledging allegiance to the great mystics of Madison Avenue to spread his message. He couldn't abide it because he feels too deeply, and he knows too well what to believe and what obligates him to do. To borrow from Adlai Stevenson, Ron Paul's patriotism is the steady and tranquil devotion of a lifetime, and I'm honored to introduce and encourage you to support Ron Paul. These are truths of strange times. We have to look hard for someone we can truly admire. But we found one among ourselves of such great character and learning that we must act as patriots who would show ourselves to the world who are by now so great how good a man we are willing to follow, even if the guy doesn't have a $400 haircut or sound like he was born to be on television. We found a man that we can support with all our hearts. We want to elevate Ron Paul to the White House. He's a man that we can point to our children and say, here's a real patriot in the sense of Patrick Henry, of George Washington, of John C. Calhoun. They're all the great individuals who fought for liberty in this conscience, in this continent. A few weeks ago, my son and I spent some wonderful time with some wonderful Christian friends in the British Isles. We had a wonderful fellowship, and they were wonderful individuals. And I said, wonderful enough, I hope you get the message. But these individuals talk about their dream of a restored British Empire. They talked about their dream of a government that supported them from cradle to grave. And I began to think about our American forebears. I began to think about individuals who landed here without any promise of a job, without any promise of any social underpinnings from government. I thought about individuals who cleared stumps and who fought out and cleared themselves away that they might build an humble log cabin that they might fend for themselves. And I said, that's the American dream. Free enterprise, liberty, independence, not national interdependence on the United Nations, but independence. Someday I intend to die because, like Dr. Ron Paul says, I have accepted Jesus Christ as my Savior. I intend to go to heaven in that day. And on that day, I want to see Patrick Henry, and I want to see George Washington, and I want to see John C. Calhoun, and say, that which you fought for is that which we still stand for in this land. This cause is too great and this land is too wonderful to ever try to bend or compromise those principles. There is one way that I know that I can make a statement to bring the adrift Republican Party back to principles. And that is by voting today and in the February 5th primary for the most principled man on the scene, the congressman, the patriot, and by God's help, our next president, Dr. Ron Paul.
Mayor Rudy Giuliani received 7 votes. Governor Mike Huckabee received 6 votes. Congressman Duncan Hunter received 10 votes. And we do really appreciate him calling in. As a matter of fact, earlier this week, I did get a call saying that he was going to see if he could arrange his schedule to have been here in person. But he's still in Texas. I think that would have been incredible if we could have got a presidential candidate to come to our event. But he had 10 votes. Senator John McCain had 2 votes. I'm actually going to skip the next one for just a second because, like I said, we all know who won. Governor Mitt Romney had 14 votes. Congressman Tom Tancredo received no votes. Senator Fred Thompson received 9 votes. Now, there were 266 votes cast, and the winner of the West Alabama Republican Assembly 2007 presidential preference straw poll, August the 18th of 2007, with 216 votes, is Congressman Ron Paul.